is also somebody who's competent and capable and is effective as a contributor to the profession and to the general industry. So that's the idea behind this thought. We're just beginning it. Hopefully we'll be able to achieve something out of it.
Thanks a lot, Abhishek, for making it. In a nutshell, the entire idea is to pull in all possible resources and resources for the higher technical education where scholarships are in lesser amount. There is a large number of students, a survey conducted by us, have a lot of concern about the rising fees and the tuition fee and the residential cost and all. So we want to enable that no student, no aspiring meritorious engineering student should suffer from I will say not provision of education because of want of resources and funds. We look forward for all your support in taking it forward. I would like to, before inviting the honorable jury members and the honorable guests of eminence to speak for a few moments about their with their words of encouragement, I would request Sushil sir to please hand over a token of thanks to RL Gupta sir for making it to this occasion. Token of thanks to RL Gupta sir. RL Gupta sir heads the IEC group of institutions, which has a major university in Baddi and an engineering college in Greater Noida. And he has been training the engineering colleges. He has been one of the very earliest proponents of computer education by his IEC group. I would request Gupta sir to please speak for 2 minutes about the great good work which his institution has been doing for the larger benefit of the audience. I would request the dignitaries to please be seated. Yeah.
Sir. Welcome to all and all my best wishes to all. And respect to all the members of the jury and the other gentlemen. I myself independently started with 500 rupees the computer education in 1981. And up to 98, I was doing the business only of the computer education. Then in 1998, I started the university with the name of the IEC University. IEC College of Engineering and Technology in Greater Noida. Last year, 2 years back, I arranged the one university by the name of IEC University in Himachal Pradesh. That's my all to you. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. I would now request Shri Girdhar Gulati ji to please receive a token of thanks from Sushil sir. I request Girdhar sir to please speak for a few words about their journey into the engineering education space from a transport corporation to an engineering education major. Sir.
Thank you very much. First of all, I thanks the management that they have invited me and given such a high regard. I have to say nothing. Since 1985, we jumped into education from our other businesses of transport and automobiles. Earlier, we were departing the diploma engineering, computer science, and other subjects. Later, when the privatization comes into the picture in 1997 in Uttar Pradesh, we started our education career from Allahabad, and then in 2005 we came to Greater Noida Presently, we are having 9 technical institutions, 6 at Allahabad and 3 at Greater Noida. But as rightly my brother Abhishek was telling, you see, since we are one of the founders in the Uttar Pradesh, we have 4 times of scholarships. And another burden has been given upon us about the AICT, because all over from the 5% seats we have to give the free. So my friend was saying that a small token scholarship be given to the students. We are already educating 5% of total. We are having a strength of 8,000 students in our institutions, and we are providing free education to the 5%. You calculate what we are doing for the society. And we are meant to help the society with our own efforts. We don't bother about whatever the funds are being utilized there. But one thing I say, that the engineer Watch is doing a wonderful work. They are coming into different fields. Today I find that they are going to have all over India, the peoples are here under the one banner. So it's a good achievement for them. Earlier when they came into the picture, they were simply for the engineering colleges, I think so. Anyhow, my thanks to you, the organizers, and my dear old friends who are sitting over the dais, and my thanks to all you. You have listened to me. Okay.
Thanks a lot, sir. I would now request Mr. C.S. Prasad to please receive a token of thanks from the Honorable Convener of Engineering Excellence Awards, Sri Sushil, sir. Sir, the awardees would love to hear a few words of encouragement from you, please.
Honorable MP sir, Sri SK Singh ji, dignitaries on the dais, and August gathering in the house. First of all, I thank the Engineering Watch to have organized such a decent opportunity for selecting Engineering Excellence Awards from all walks of engineering and pan-India scene. This is a wonderful gathering of the national achievements in the past few years over various fields of engineering, where we had many projects of power projects, many building projects, and even multiple roti making machines. So we had Rudra helicopter and what not. So right from any field of engineering, we think it was mostly covered over here. So engineering have been given a recognition today in this gathering, and the people who have put their hard work into it, they have been suitably awarded. India had been having this tradition right from many ancient and Puranic days, when we know that Vishwakarma, Lord Vishwakarma, is the symbol of engineering and Puranic recognition is to him. In a single day time, he could build castles, and our friends have constructed T+20 in 4 months time with prefab. This is wonderful achievement in today's scenario. This will go a long way to solve the current challenges before the country. And myself, being at the moment I am president in Indian Building Congress, and very much concerned for the built environment problems, challenges, solutions, and concerned for the engineering as a profession, and I am also addressing various branches, various other professions who are concerned with the built environment, architects, builders, vendors, suppliers, all together. So Engineering Watch is giving a good coverage, and they are also thinking for the students and teaching, because teaching is the seed. So it is overall this perspective of Engineering Watch. This is my first exposure with them, and I have just by accident I came across with them. I got their email and I responded, and Devang, since then Devang is had been in touch with me, and I am thankful to him. I am working here itself, so it was very convenient for me to come over here and witness. I congratulate all the participants and all those who have been, who have received awards, and I also give the message that please don't consider to be the end here. This is your beginning. You think of more innovations, more of problem solutions, and forget China or other country. We can build anything within with our indigenous efforts. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir, for your encouraging words. I would now request Professor N.K. Goyal to please accept a token of thanks from Sushil, sir. Really thank you, sir, for making it to the occasion and encouraging awardees. We would love to have a few words of your encouragement, sir.
Honorable Member of Parliament of the Dais, Vice Chancellor Professor Kak and Sarma, you know personally, and others here. I must say hats off and compliments to Raghav, Ravi and his team for such a wonderful initiative. Encompass, I think, the entire horizon we can think of. I wish him all the success in the life, and also to all of you. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. I would request Professor Bhunia, the Honorable Director of NIT Arunachal Pradesh, and he has been an august member of our jury, to please accept a token of thanks from Sushil, sir. Professor Bhunia. So since you have been an eminent member of the jury, the awardees would love to know about your candid evaluation for 2 minutes as to how you went through the same.
Mr. Mittal and his team, Honorable MP Sushil ji, other dignitaries present in the dais, and distinguished audience. Engineering Watch as such was not known to me before 2012, when I was given an interview at IIT Delhi guest house. After that, I was looking into what this organization was doing. The amazing way they did this conference to award the best talent, the best innovators, deserved all around accolades. In fact, we are talking of the China's, we are talking of the other countries' development, but actually speaking, to become China-like country, developed-like country, we need to change our mindset. Today, we need innovators, not regulators. That is how we need to change our education systems. If I have really understood, and to my personal opinion, the engineering education in India today are plagued because of two things. Our engineering education systems are producing, in general, academic engineers rather than technical engineers. At the same time, we are producing engineers, in general, those who run after jobs rather than create jobs. Therefore, we could not be competitor in the global market in innovations, in creativity and other research. We have to look after these problems plaguing our technical education systems. I personally believe the technical education systems will be successful only when we'll make this educations entrepreneurship-based educations. Today, due to private participations in education systems, we have an opportunity and potentiality, and that opportunity potentiality needs our mindset to think of why not this private institute would club with private industries so that industry institute run together and do the excellence for the country. I am thankful to the Engineering Watch organizations for inviting me as a jury as well as a guest over here, and I congratulate the winners of today's functions, and I hope the Engineering Watch will go a long way to meet the aspirations of national leaders. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. I would now request Professor S.K. Kag to please receive a token of thanks from Sri Sushil Singh Ji. Professor Kag has been a constant patron and a constant mentor and a source of motivation for us at Engineering Watch especially. Thanks a lot, sir, for your esteemed presence despite your extremely busy schedule. And we would really love to hear a few words of encouragement from you, sir.
Thank you, Raghav. I think the kind of jury that you have collected together, the kind of awards that were given, and the kind of thought leadership that you have shown is remarkable. I congratulate you for that. I congratulate all the winners for participating and making us proud that India is creative, making us proud that even in this area, we are in engineering area also, we are producing marvels, and something for which we need to keep our heads high. I'm sure there are many more marvels to come, and thanks to Engineering Watch, they will be known, they will be heard, they will be admired, and they will be seeing the light of the day. It's not only that the effort that goes into making these marvels, but the appreciation and other things that need to be done are remarkable. Once again, I congratulate Engineering Watch for this idea. He has been producing wonderful ideas. I think it's high time that some people help and put out a hand of help to him so that these particular ideas can flower and can bring out more such new idioms and technology leadership in terms of analytics, in terms of how we can really make a difference in the engineering education, engineering production, and engineering creativity. Thank you once again. Thank you all.
Extremely thankful, sir, for your kind words. I would now request Professor P.B. Sharma to please receive a token of thanks from Sushil Singh, sir. I request Professor Sharma to please illumine the audience with his characteristic humor style. He has been one of the most eminent members of the jury as to how he got upon as the best engineering marvels across.
Sir, Honorable Member of Parliament, Sri Singh Sahab, my very distinguished members of the jury, ladies and gentlemen, let me at the outset congratulate Engineering Watch, Mr. Raghava, Mr. Ravi and their team for taking such a great initiative to recognize tremendous amount of positivity which we have in the arena of engineering services in this country. The idea of recognizing engineering marvels, rewarding and awarding engineering excellence for organizations and individuals who are doing an outstanding job for the country is something highly laudable. Often in our country, we are overburdened by condemnation which we offer for things which fall in the domain of negativity. And it is because of our greater attention to the negativity, often we find that much of the positivity which does exist in this country sustains the march of excellence in this country and take this country forward to new frontiers of glory and enlightenment, often remain unrecognized and unrewarded. Therefore, this initiative of Engineering Watch, in my opinion, is the most laudable one, and I wish to congratulate them for this initiative. Let me also say that excellence requires a passion. It requires a lifelong commitment to the work activity. It requires paying the greatest attention to the minutest details. It requires creating winning teams and inspiring every team member, no matter what little or more work he or she has been assigned, to give his very best to the work activity of which the team is really is a great achiever. And therefore, it's very important for people like us who are in the arena of engineering and technology activity to understand that it requires creating a junoon of the kind in the members of our team who should give their lifeblood only for the purpose of creating that perfectionist attitude in them so that they create the marvels of the kind which the world will rejoice. Let me finish by saying that creating engineering marvels requires, in my opinion, that we must pay attention to what I call the design for excellence. Often we think that excellence will emerge over a period of time. Therefore, let us take the first step and let it start moving. That's not so. In fact, excellence requires, in my opinion, design for excellence. You can design for excellence and commission it with perfection, and from the day one, it glows that vital eminence of the excellence for which the marvel is created. Taj Mahal has been designed for excellence, and from the day one, it was the world attraction. It did not require decades for people to appreciate the kind of eminence which it represents in the form of engineering excellence. Same is the case with Delhi Metro, and same is the case with very many magnificent terminals put together by Airport Authority of India in our country. For a very long time, we were saying our terminals no good. Today, whole world is saying the terminals in India are the very best. Same applies to putting our very best effort to designing and developing 150-ton trailer purely to be run on batteries with the support of electricity only. This would pave the way for tomorrow's India, where such a positivity is being recognized in the form of engineering excellence by Engineering Watch. Therefore, on this evening, now that we have overstepped our time in this hall, and they will throw us out otherwise in few minutes, I think let me finish by congratulating each one of the winners of the Engineering Excellence Award 2013 and congratulate Engineering Watch for such a bold initiative. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks a lot, sir, for your insightful words. I would now request Mr. R.K. Vaish, the Chief Resident Commissioner, Government of Tripura, to please receive a token of thanks from the Honorable Convener, Sri Sushil Kumar Singh Ji. Thank you.
encouragement.
Respected Honorable Member of Parliament and dignitaries of the dais and dear colleagues, this today's function to honor and award the engineering marvels, I think is a very unique function. I do not recollect occasions when, you know, engineering marvels in our country like this have been, you know, honored and recognized. And indeed, this is a very, very, very unique initiative, very timely initiative of recognizing the engineering marvels. Because if we do not do this, I believe we can't have a re-engineered India. And if we want to have a re-engineered India, we have to have excellence in, you know, in the midst of our engineers. And as somebody in the just in the beginning said that, you know, in this country, like IIMs, we tend to spoil engineers. We make them managers. How many institutions are there in this country where engineers are taught towards excellence or encouraged systematically towards achieving excellence and higher excellence, and that excellence is recognized? I think that this initiative today is a very positive initiative, and I think this will pave the way for bigger initiatives in times to come, when, you know, your achievements in your fields will be recognized in a greater manner. And you know, we like to pay back to you the due regard and the honor that your efforts, you know, you have been putting your efforts. And from that point of view, what has been done by Engineering Watch, I think, is very creditworthy, very praiseworthy. These young people have done something, they have tried to do something what many of us in the government system have not yet done, or probably we are contemplating to do. And I would like to congratulate all the award winners today. My esteemed colleague on the dais said, excellence is a matter of passion. And those who achieve excellence, they have given their passion to it. They have given their sweat to it. And if we are recognizing it, I think we are doing our duty to it, towards it. I would like to congratulate once again Engineering Watch for such a marvelous effort. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir, for your words of encouragement. Last but not the least, I would request